85 AD, but there today is what we care about. This the semi-finalist for the second semi-final of the Prague Open 2015. Eduarda Duda, 16 years of age. Her partner is Elise Maia Secomanda. She's 30 years of age. The Brazilians are dancing in the aisles. They've already got one pair into the final. They want two. But standing in this in their way on this fairly breezy, fairly cool May morning or early afternoon, it's just ticked into the afternoon, is Bansley and Pavin of Canada. It's 17 degrees C here. It's not the warmest. They knocked out the Finns in the semi-final, Lahti and Lentinen, in three sets. They fought back and they'll be hoping to fight as hard as they can against that Brazilian pairing there. Eduarda Lisboa and Elise Maia. It's going to be a very, very difficult game for both pairs, but especially for the 16-year-old Eduarda on the right in the pink sunglasses. There's Heather Bansley. She's got a lot of experience in beach volleyball. Her partner, Sarah Pavin, doesn't have as much. She's more of an indoor specialist who took to beach volleyball in the aim of getting to the Olympic Games. The first referee, David Prati of Italy. The second is Carlos Rivera. He is from Paraguay. Sorry, Puerto Rico. Carlos Rivera from Puerto Rico. He'll be down on the sand, making sure everything runs as smoothly as it can. And introducing, of course, the two teams. She's 16 years of age. She's the third youngest ever semi-finalist. She's a huge talent. Brazil are looking to her to carry them in the women's beach volleyball game beyond 2016. Eduarda is a real star of the future. And her partner, Elise Maia Secomanda. Well, the pair fought hard through the qualifiers to be here. Elise has been on tour for 7 years, but only won $12,000 over 10 tournaments. There's Sarah Pavin. On court, she comes 6'5", former indoor player for the Canadian national team. She played in Italy for a couple of years and spent a year in Seoul in Korea. And taking a deep breath in before coming out, Heather Bansley. They played together since 2013. It's their first semi-final together on the FIVB World Tour, but the third time that a Canadian pair have made the FIVB World Tour semi-finals in 2015. Broda and Valdias have been the form team of the tour so far. They crashed out though in the first round of qualifying after the pool stages. They won in Fuzhou and came third in Lucerne. They lead the way in the World Tour ranking points, which of course all count towards Copacabana Beach and Rio 2016. Heather Bansley is going to serve for the Canadian team. They're in the white. In the black tops are the Brazilian pairing of Eduarda and Elise. And Bansley serves straight into the net and hands service back over. That won't be what Bansley was looking for, obviously. From London in Ontario, stands just 5'7", by far away the shortest member, not only of the Canadian team, but of any player on court today. But Bansley can do that. She spikes through the defences of Eduarda and Elise. Lovely technique, just fingertips from each of the Brazilians. Pavin serves. Eduarda for Elise. Elise right-handed. Bainsley down to the sand. Oh, probably could have let that go there. Elise didn't, and it keeps the Canadians in the point with a spike. Great defense from Eduarda. Pavin, left-handed Eduarda into the net. And the second point of the afternoon goes the Canadians' way. What a story it would be if Canada could get their second finalists into it. World Tour event in 2015. Duda just showing her inexperience slightly. That time the point going the way of the Brazilians. Heather Bansley couldn't quite get across to it. Elise Maia, 30 years of age. Look at how that died, clipping the net on its way through the serve. 2-2 the score. make that 3-2 to the Canadians. Bansley put it up, Pavant no doubt put it down through Elise's defences. Duda into the left-hand side of the court, comfortably done. Seven matches they played so far. They beat Golova and Nakladalova of the Czech Republic in the first round of qualifying. 4-3, Duda with the serve as we change courts for the first time. Then it was, and there is in fact the statistic about Eduarda, 16 years, 9 months, 23 days. Where will she finish in Prague? Well, Ying Huang of China and Zhi Ying Zhi of China, both younger than her when they entered semi-finals. She can't become the youngest to win a gold because Yi Huang has already done that. Already beaten her to it. 4-4 the score. Impressively, the Brazilian pairing beat Chantal Labarra and Julia Suda of Germany, the number 3 seeds in the semi-final. A pair who performed well in Fuzhou. Defence of Pavan gets the point against Elise at the net. Suddenly Pavan and Bansley with work rate have a 2-point advantage. Huge mismatch in height between those two, 6-5 and 5-7, but it works well. Bansley serves, right-handed, jump serve. Duda power, brilliant stuff. She was born in Espinosa just 16 years ago, 1st of August 1998. Makes me feel insanely old. Frustration from Eduarda. Saying that, she must make Elise feel old as well, and she's only just turns 31 in October. Well saved by Bansley. Up she comes for the spike down the sideline. The point goes the Brazilian's way because she missed the sideline that time. 7-6 the score. Pavant and Bansley just lead the way here in the first, looking to break up the monopoly that the Brazilians have here in Prague 2015. Bansley sets, digs for Pavant, who spikes for the point. We change courts at 8-6. I was talking with Jamie Broder and Christina Valias just after Fuzhou, and they were saying that the facilities they have in Canada are really helping the Canadian pairings make headway on the world scene, on the FIVB World Tour. Toronto has an indoor sand arena that they can use. There's also excellent facilities down at the beaches in Toronto as well. And it's helping and it's showing because the Canadians have been the dominant force in 2015, which is somewhat of a surprise. A spike from Pavan there. Elise, up she goes. Limited experience on the World Tour for the 30-year-old. Played with a number of partners on the Brazilian Continental Tour. Helps herself to a point as Pavan backed off, and she spikes the ball into the defences of Heather Bansley. A serve from Elise Pavan. Elise backed off, it hit Eduarda. 10-8 now, the score. Nothing to worry about for the Brazilian pair at the moment. The raw talent of Eduarda. Bansley serves, Elise down low. Her only Grand Slam was in 2013. Picking up another point. That Grand Slam for Elise was in Sao Paulo. And Bansley once more can't keep the ball in play. Pavan can't get there. 10 points apiece. Eduarda serves. Bansley off the block of Elise. Pavan does get there. Bansley can dig the ball back over the net. Good work rate from the Canadians, and Bansley helps herself to the point in the end, but they had to work so hard for it. That was super stuff from the Canadian pairing. Heather Bansley, who won a silver medal at the Norcheca Beach Championships in Puerto Vallarta with Liz Maloney in 2010. Puerto Vallarta, of course, in Mexico. And her work rate there was absolutely magnificent. So 11-10, we go to a technical timeout. You have to think that for Pavan and Bansley, this is the best opportunity for them to make their way into a final, facing an inexperienced Brazilian pairing. So in their second beach volleyball World Tour event together for Eduarda and Elise. Eduarda has $7,188 in victory money. There's the score, 11-10 to the Canadians. Elise, $12,213. Over 10 tournaments and 7 seasons. Twice she's finished as an equal fifth, which means she lost in the quarterfinals in 2 events on the World Tour. She's better that here. Oh, and she's come up against Sarah Pavan. 6'5", towering. And the block was magnificent. Yesterday, against the Finnish pairing, she looked rather naive in her blocks at times. Rather easy to read. But that was superb. And again, once more. The brick wall of Pavan. And she will serve once more. Just snatching the line, kissing the line on the way through, and suddenly, Pavan and Bansley. Pavan and Bansley have a 4-point lead here. Duda just over the net. Pavan just pushes the ball over the top of the Brazilian pairing. Timeout called as the Brazilians have fallen to pieces here. Duda probably could have set Elise up there, didn't do so. Pavan found it all too easy to sneak the point once more. It's the 20th time they played in an FIVB Beach Volleyball World Tour event together over the last couple of seasons. Their first final four, their first semi-final. Those two. The Brazilian pairing, Duda and Elise. Just their second tournament, so equally their first ever semi-final. Both pairings having experience in the semi-finals. Both will enter the final as underdogs against Agata and Barbara, who were marvellous earlier on today. Both will be hoping to add points to their tally heading towards Rio. You'd have to say two such competitive countries as Brazil and Canada. They really do have a lot to do, and Pavan once more adds a point at the net. She's playing superbly this morning, supported by the terrier-like Heather Bansley. Great stuff. From Kitchener in Ontario, Sarah Pavan. Duda into the net. There's the inexperience shining through. And at the moment, this first set is only going one way. The 16-year-old didn't really need to go for that one. And she saw Sarah Pavan there. Forced her hand. Pavan serves, clips the net, lucky. Elise Verduda. Pavan Bansley jumping through, only 5-7. Up off the defences of Eduarda once more. 18 points to 10. And where did this set go wrong for the Brazilians? Well, they've been dominated since that technical timeout. Elise getting herself back into the points, but she's barely been allowed to have any threat at all in the middle part of the set. Elise to serve, former partner of Fernanda Alves. Finished 25th. In Prague in 2014. Pavan digs, Bansley spikes, and she splits the difference between Duda and Elise. 19-11 the score, and you felt the Canadians were behind in that point, and then suddenly Elise left it for Eduarda. And Eduarda looked back at her elder colleague with nothing but bemusement on her face. Off Elise. Pavan helps herself once more, and it's becoming all too easy for this Canadian pairing. The Brazilians look at sixes and sevens currently. Is it one step too far for the Brazilian pairing, who have gone seven straight wins in a row to be here through qualifying, winning their group, beating Broda and Valias to boot. They get a point back, 20-12 against Broda and Valias of Canada, 21-17, 21-15 in Pool H. Huge off day for the Canadian pairing, who won in Fuzhou, started their 2015 campaign so well. Pavan and Bansley have started this semi-final in a super fashion. 12-21, it goes the way of the Canadian pairing. And it's been an absolute domination from Bansley and Pavan in the first set here, in the second semi-final of the Prague Open 2015. Of course, the final later on, Agata and Barbara have taken their places. Maria Clara and Carol have to go into the third, fourth playoff. Who will they face? Will it be the Canadians? Will it be the Brazilians? Well, at the moment, Bansley and Pavan lead the way. Home's place. Well, there are the statistics from the first set. An ace apiece. Service errors going slightly more weighted towards the Brazilians with 3-2. Blocks Pavan with 2 for herself. 18 attacks to 21. The Brazilians led with 21. But the efficiency all with the Canadians, and a very comfortable first set victory and a very comfortable first point. Comprehensively played there by Heather Bansley. 1-0. The spike from Pavan. Bansley drilling. Sorry, the dig from Pavan. And Bansley drilling the spike into the sand. Duda just dinking the ball over the top. Pavan for Bansley into the backcourt. 2-0 the score. And you just, even though we're only 2 points up in this set so far, you can't see where the Brazilians are going to come back from. Duda looks disconsolate at the moment. It's better. Elise can get herself a point that time. That was more like it from the Brazilian pairing. The Brazilian football shirt waved with pride. The team that didn't perform at the Football World Cup last year, when it so mattered in the semi-final, was Brazil. Can this Brazilian pairing do better? 3-1 the score. Pavan to serve. Elise, right-handed spike. Great save from Bansley, up in a flash to get the point. Duda couldn't keep the ball in play. Eduarda Lisboa, or Duda as she's known, the right-handed dive from Bansley was magnificent, and then the spike, too powerful for the 16-year-old. Elise with the spike. Bansley saves. Comes back to spike herself. 5-1. Well, both semi-finals have been, unfortunately, fairly similar. There's been one dominant pairing across both. We haven't seen a hard-fought, close battle in either so far. Timeout called, and Elise trying to talk to the youngster Duda, trying to pass on advice. They need to salvage some pride here. At the moment, Pavan and Bansley are running away. With this second semi-final, Eduarda and Elise lost 21-12 in the first. They're 5-1 down in the second. Can they make it to the final against Agata or Barbara, or will they have to settle for Maria Clara and Carol in the third, fourth playoff, the bronze medal playoff? Elise off the net. Bansley saves, gets back up and digs for all she's worth. Elise wins the point and takes us to a change of court. Leading the money list for 2015 is the other Canadian pair of Broda and Valias. There's Heather Bansley, who's a competitive dancer from a young age. Which was first way of getting into physical activity in sports. Sarah Pavan, more of an all-round sportswoman from a young age, makes it 6-2. Of course, Heather Bansley qualified Canada for London 2012 in beach volleyball, but then lost in the Canadian trials. It must be such a gutting way to miss out on Olympic Games when you've qualified your country's spot and then you don't get that spot. Elise to serve. Good save from Duda. One Youth Olympic gold in Nanjing. Doesn't win the point though. 7-3 the score now. Came up against Pavan at the net. Was unable to get around her. And the ball ricocheting. All she could do was try and clip it back with that left hand. Elise. Easy point for her on that occasion. Just spiking into the backcourt. Over the top of Pavan, who was a little bit further off the net than she would have liked. Can't salvage the point either as Heather Bansley's dig goes awry. Easy for Bansley that time. 9-8 the score. Former University of Toronto Athlete of the Year. Read linguistics and English literature. At the moment, the Canadians 8-5 up. Make that 8-6 as Bansley's serve clatters into the net and then clatters into Sarah Pavan also. Change of court. Eight points to six. Can the Canadians cling on and close out this semi-final, their first ever in two sets? Bansley gets herself the point. Eduarda won the Youth Olympic Games in Nanjing with Anna Patricia Silva in 2014. Nice. Elise. Bansley will come through to spike. Yes. Off Duda gets the point. And again, the Canadian pairing just pulling away from this Brazilian pair, who have improved in the last few points. They were 5-1 down. 10-6 the score. Elise off the net. Bansley to the sand and keeps it alive. Out of play it goes though. Point going back the Brazilian way. As Eduarda and Elise delighted to see that that time Heather Bansley did make an error. Look of concentration on Heather Bansley's face. Yeah. Oh, super stuff at the net from Sarah Pavan once more. Getting up above. Elise at the net. And just, did she get the touch? Was it Elise straight into the net? I think it might have been. 11-7. Duda, Elise. Off Pavan, Bansley can't get there. She backed herself to get there. Heather Bansley, look at the change of direction, and wasn't far away either. Down the left-hand sideline as Heather Bansley looked. The 27-year-old makes no mistake. Just 1 year younger than her Canadian partner. 12-8 the score. Elise off the net. Well kept alive. Pavan has the opportunity. She'll set once more for Bansley. Elise doing the blocking, and it's back under the control of the Canadian pair. Bansley over the top and just on the line. 13-8 the score. We go to a technical timeout after a fantastic rally. Sarah Pavan with the dig. Bansley just keeping the ball in play. Disappointing semi-final so far for the youngster, but experience is what she needs at this point in time. She needs the time on court, gaining experience to become a better player at the world level. Just 16 years of age. It's different coming from the Youth Olympic Games to this level. Come up against experienced players like Heather Bansley, experienced indoor players like Sarah Pavan. 13-9, Pavan with the service error. Duda serves. Bansley with the spike, kept alive by Duda, and then not kept alive by Elise. 14-9 the score. Bansley, jump serve, Duda, Elise with the spike, Pavan at the net, Duda just kept it alive, that was all she could do, and then Sarah Pavan decides to change her hands on the spike, put a lot of deception on it, claims a 15th point for her team in this set. Wow, amazing acrobatics there from Heather Bansley. But wasted in the end after all that effort. The Brazilians stole the point anyway. Amazing stuff from Bansley. Pavan not too bad either with her diving to her right. But in the end, Elise Meyer off Pavan for the point. 15-10 the score. Make that 16, Heather Bansley. Clinching another point for a team. Are the Canadians going to ruin the Brazilian beach party here in Prague, here in this stunning city of history and culture? 17-11. The Stavnici Stadium has been kind to the Brazilians, especially to Duda and Elise, until they came up against this Canadian pairing. The first Canadian pairing they faced, they beat. The second, at the moment, they are having no luck against whatsoever. 16-11. Seventeen-11 is the score. Bansley again. Such an athlete. And then comes in with the spike off Elise Meyer. Just 4 points left for the Canadians. They won't get one of them with Sarah Pavan's serve. 17-12. Poor from the 6'5" Pavan. Played for the Waterloo Tigers, winning a national championships in Canada in indoor volleyball. Bansley. Duda. Pavan. Duda was there and defended well. Comes in with the spike. And gets the point. Elise is delighted. Celebrated like she just won the Prague Open 2015, when in fact Duda had just played an exceptionally good point, and it really was good. And that was what Elise was celebrating, was the coming together of this partnership with good beach volleyball. And it puts pressure on Sarah Pavan there. 17-14. Open. A timeout called. 17-14 the score. The Canadians do not need much more to claim their place against Agata and Barbara in the final. What have they got? Elise. Between, they've won $1,687.50 in Lucerne in 2015. That was just last week, and 150 ranking points. It's taken them three sets, more than any other pair in the semi-final. But equally, looking at the results, they have played more games. Took them three sets against the Polish pair and the Lithuanian and German pair as well. The Canadians, but it was only their semi-final against Tahu Lahti and Riikka Leitonen of Finland, the number 16 seeds, that went to three, eventually winning in 45 minutes, 15-10 in the third. 18-14 for the Canadians now. Sarah Pavan delighted. And Bansley has herself another serve. Duda has to drop back. Elise Meyer. It was a poor piece of play in the first instance. Then her spike going wrong, and Duda glares at her. Elise knows she did wrong. She doesn't need telling by some young upstart 16-year-old. Bansley now to play. 19-15 the score. Elise will go to the service line once more. Look at that, seven service errors from the Canadians. And three, make that four for the Brazilians. And now, of course, match point. Well, the Canadians could become the second Canadian pairing of 2015 to make it to an open final. The first pair, Broda and Valias, won it in Fuzhou. And there you have it. The Canadian pair of Bansley and Pavan win 21 points to 15. In the second set, 21-12, 21-15 the score. Well, it was an impressive performance by the team in white, but the Brazilians just did not turn up this morning. Duda and Elise Meyer going down 21-12, 21-15 on the sand of Prague, unable to win their way through to their first ever FIVB World Tour beach volleyball gold medal match, final match. Instead, that honour goes to the Canadian pairing of Bansley and Pavan. Elise Meyer worked hard with a young partner this week. They could still, of course, claim third place and those all-important points and dollars. For Bansley, lucky there, it was only just on the line. But this will go down as an experience builder for Duda. For Bansley and Pavan, shows that Canadian beach volleyball really is at the moment a powerhouse and really is on the map. Of course, class the Brazilians and the Americans as the top two countries in the world, but Canada are doing excellently across the open events. It might change when we come to the Grand Slams and the majors, but at the moment, Canada are the flag that are flying the highest in the first three open events on the women's tour in 2015. Well, there's the statistics. Duda and Elise, two aces to Bansley and Pavans, one. Seven service errors for the Canadians. They'll need to improve that in the final later on against Agata and Barbara. Three blocks for Sarah Pavan. She was superb at the net. 68% attack efficiency against 33% attack efficiency says it all. In a few moments, I should say, we'll be hearing from Tim Simmons, who will be talking to Heather and Sarah down on the sand. But 68% to 33% says it all. I'm going to go over to Tim, who's got Heather and Sarah courtside.
Congratulations, you're going to be playing your first gold medal match, and Canada's hot this year.
Yeah, we're so excited. Brazil played really well, and we're really excited for this opportunity. Had to break up the podium a little bit, but yeah, this is a great opportunity for us, and we hope to keep going from here. We're not done yet.
Obviously, you have to be thrilled with your play today, beating a pretty good Brazilian team. What was the difference in the match?
I think Sarah did a really good job blocking them and playing at the net and sort of taking away their offense, and she made my job easy in the backcourt.
What is the difference with the Canadians this year? Was it the preseason training?
I don't know. It's been a long time coming for us. We've been grinding it out, and our country's been getting good finishes so far, and I'm really proud of our country as a whole.
What'd you think about Duda, 16 years old? Would you like to have been playing at that high level at 16?
Of course. I mean, I think it's a great opportunity for her to compete at this level and just get that experience. And she's a great player, and she's only going to get better from here.
Sarah, you're going to be playing a very experienced Brazilian team out there. What's going to be the key to your match against Agatha and Barbara?
I think the main thing for us is to just take care of our side of the net, work on our side-out game. And obviously, they're a very good team. They're going to score their points. But if we take care of our side, we'll be okay.
Well, congratulations and good luck.
Thank you.
Well, there you go. The Canadian pairing will just concentrate on their own game. They'll look to dominate the Prague Open 2015 final against Agata and Barbara as best they can. As Tim said, Canadian beach volleyball is hot at the moment. Brazilian beach volleyball is hot most of the time. Can the Canadians really upset the apple cart here in Prague and claim gold against Barbara and Agata? We'll have all the action coming up later on here in Prague. These are the highlights of the second semi-final. For the finals now, Agata and Barbara versus Bansley and Pavan of Canada. The third, fourth playoff will be between Elise Meyer and Eduarda or Duda, and Maria Clara and Carol, the Salgado sisters. So it's Brazil-Canada in the final and Brazil versus Brazil for the third, fourth playoff in the Prague Open of 2015. The all-important ranking points going towards Rio will be decided when we see you later on here by the banks of the meandering Vltava River. The Prague 2015 Open